NASA's most ambitious Martian rover ever is on its way to the Red Planet. This is your space pod for November 28th, 2011.
Roger. Status check. Go Atlas. Go Centaur.
T-minus 15 seconds. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Main engine start, zero, and liftoff of the Atlas V with Curiosity, seeking clues to the planetary puzzle about life on Mars.
NASA's Mars Science Laboratory mission lifted off the launch pad atop an Atlas V rocket on November 26, 2011 at 15:02 Coordinated Universal Time. Now, this isn't just another rocket launch or rover being sent to the Red Planet. I could tell you how this is the largest lander we've ever sent to Mars and is nearly the size of a Mini Cooper. I could tell you that this is the heaviest rover that we've sent to the fourth planet, coming in at over 2,000 pounds. But instead, I think William Pomerantz described this mission best at his LA Space Salon talk.
For anyone who doesn't recognize it, this is Mars Science Lab, also known as Curiosity. This launches 2 weeks from Friday, one week from Friday, the day after Thanksgiving. My wife works on this mission. I'm gonna go see it launch. I think it's amazing. I think whoever designed that, the sky crane landing system, which really briefly is, instead of landing on the surface, this thing is gonna hover under rocket power a dozen meters off the surface, or less than that, and it's gonna lower a rover down on a cable while these eight rocket engines are firing in perfect precision until the rover's wheels touch down on the surface of Mars, and then it has to blow an explosive bolt and that rocket stage has to fly somewhere else so it doesn't land on top. That is a crazy idea. Whoever suggested that, I hope it had a couple drinks before walking into that meeting. Never say NASA doesn't take risk.
Needless to say, the MSL mission with the Curiosity rover will be a nail-biter as the vehicle enters, descends, and then lands on the Martian surface. To make things even more dramatic, Mars is far enough away that radio signals will take around 10 minutes to reach Earth. In fact, it's so far that by the time we start to get the radio signals telling us that the craft is about to begin its entry into the Martian atmosphere, the vehicle will already be on the ground, hopefully in one piece. Now, if everything goes according to plan, then on August 5th, 2012, the Curiosity rover will begin roaming the Gale crater on Mars. Now, we're not just sending Curiosity to Mars for fun. This giant rover has several missions it will attempt to accomplish in one Martian year, which is nearly 2 years here on Earth. The goals are to determine if life could have ever been there, characterize the climate and geology of this alien world, and finally, help prepare for human exploration of the Red Planet. Now, NASA is known for its awesome Twitter accounts, and Curiosity Rover, no exception. If you'd like to follow real-time updates via the Tweety Bird, hit up the official account at Mars Curiosity, or visit their website via the far more complicated URL, which is mars.jpl.nasa.gov/MSL, or just go to the bit.ly link at the bottom of your screen. And if you missed the launch, that's okay. There are plenty of additional rocket launches coming up, and here's a quick list of everything you can watch or tweet about. Finally, if you're a space geek or interested in what's happening within the cosmos, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click the big yellow button and new videos will automatically be added to your YouTube homepage from Spacevidcast. And we also have a Twitter account at Spacevidcast, or of course you can hit up our website. Spread the word and help us make space exciting again.